destiny that seems impossible. But I can't hear, I hear you calling me to raise a banner of love up high in your city streets. One hope for all the world to see. Be my banner of love. This love is a burning flame. One voice crying out your name. You're my banner of love. You're my banner of love. Only you can see my destiny, and only you can be the strength I need. 'Cause my life is yours, God.
want to welcome you on this beautiful, partially sunshiny day to Huntington University's 116th commencement. This is a day of celebration. Today, we celebrate the culmination of a quality, Christ-centered education at Huntington University. Today, we celebrate the supporting role that families have played in bringing these graduates up to this fine hour. And today, we celebrate the accomplishments of our graduating students and commission them for lives of Christ-centered service. This is a special day for our Huntington University community, and I know it is a special day for you as well. We are very glad that you have joined us for this ceremony of academic recognition and honor. We will be led in our invocation by Mrs. Kelly Savage, Chair of the Board of Trustees of Huntington University. Following the invocation, four music majors, Mr. Jacob Smith, a 2014 graduate, Mr. Jashawn Burks, Mr. Osvaldo Gill, and Mr. Preston Schaefer from the class of 2016 will sing "I Then Shall Live," accompanied by Huntington University Brass Ensemble. And Ms. Rosa Cruz, Senior Class President, will bring words of greeting and present the senior class gift.
Please be seated. Shall we bow our heads in prayer? Our Heavenly Father, we come before you today to lift up before you this graduating class of 2014. We praise you for the uniqueness of each student and for the special gifts you have given them. We thank you for the faculty, administration, and each person here at Huntington University who give of themselves to provide our students with a Christ-centered education. We thank you for the parents, grandparents, and family who have encouraged these students and will continue to provide encouragement throughout their journey. And we pray as these students go forward into their chosen careers, they seek you first. We pray you give them the courage to seize the opportunities you put before them. And we also pray, Lord, most of all, that they go forward and live lives that are pleasing to you and that are Christ-centered. Please bless this class of 2014 and this special day. Amen.
Thank you. Good afternoon. My name is Rosa Cruz, Senior Class President. First of all, I would like to thank God, family, friends, and mentors. I would like to thank all the professors for all the impact that they have had on us. I had a speech written down, and because my nerves got to me, I forgot to print it out. So I will talk from the heart, and I feel that that is best for me to do. My time at Huntington University has been great. The impact that this university has given me will always have true value to me in my journey onto grad school and all my journeys. Seniors, I want to remind you about God's will. I want to remind you about God's will during grad school, during your jobs. I want you to be confident when you walk into a job. I want you to be confident when you walk into a job and say, I have favor from God. I want you to not be tame. I want you to be bold. On behalf of the class of this year, we have a senior gift, and I would like to present it. And that is a swing-a-bow, and that will be right behind and right next to Roush House, and that will symbolize the class of 2014.
Rosa, I want to thank you. First of all, I want to thank you for the outstanding young woman that you've become through your college experience. And you have been so precious to me this year as my first year as president. And I want to thank you for being a fellow Texan, which is outstanding as well. And I want to thank the class of 2014 for providing this wonderful gift. Your generosity and thoughtfulness are greatly appreciated, and we will enjoy it for many years to come. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you, sir. Our scripture this afternoon will be read by Mr. Jeff Bergren. Jeff is the Vice President for Enrollment Management and Marketing at Huntington University, but today he is the father of 2014 graduate Lindsay Bergren. Jeff.
Good afternoon. Oh, this was set for Rosa height, so I may just stand behind a little bit here. Good afternoon. This is indeed a special day. I've had the opportunity and privilege for 20 years to sit with my faculty and staff colleagues and watch the students that we have come to know and appreciate move across the podium, receive a diploma, and then move on to impact our world for Christ. Those same elements are certainly in place today. But today is also different and distinctive. I get to be here as a parent for the first time of a graduating HU student, and that is very exciting. So in addition to those prior emotions, I also have the opportunity to experience the love, the joy, the pride for Lindsay and the work she's done, the accomplishment that she has achieved here at Huntington. I also get a chance to experience deep appreciation for the faculty and staff who invested in her, the gratefulness to them, the appreciation for Lindsay and her classmates, who become friends that she'll have for the rest of her life. And it's with a mixture of those feelings as a parent that I get to represent the parents and guardians of all the graduates, not only those who are of traditional undergraduate age, but also those of our adult professional programs and also graduate school. I will admit also as a parent that in the case of a traditional undergraduate like Lindsay, there's a little uncertainty. After 20 years of a pretty regimented process from preschool to pre-K to K to elementary school, middle school, high school, college, all those steps were pretty well laid out. And a little of that apprehension that goes with the future, not knowing exactly what God has in store, but excited for that possibility. So it is with that mixture of emotions and that context of sort of thoughts and feelings that I have the privilege to represent parents and guardians and share today's scripture passage with you. It's a wonderful reminder of our Lord and not only his power and majesty, but also his love and care for each one of us. This is Psalm chapter 8, verses 1 through 9. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory in the heavens. Through the praise of children and infants, you have established a stronghold against your enemies to silence the foe and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have set in place, what is mankind that you are mindful of them, human beings that you care for them? You have made them a little lower than the angels and crowned them with glory and honor. You made them rulers over the works of your hands. You put everything under their feet, all flocks and herds and the animals of the wild, the birds in the sky and the fish in the sea and all that swim in the paths of the seas. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
We are very honored to welcome Lieutenant Governor Sue Elsterman as our 2014 commencement speaker. Allow me to share with you about our Lieutenant Governor. I have had the privilege of meeting the Lieutenant Governor during our students' participation in the State Agriculture Awareness Media Competition Campaign, where I am proud to say Huntington University was awarded first place. Lieutenant Governor Sue Elsterman is the 50th person to serve in that office, and unlike most politicians, began her career in corporate business and later starting her own company. Growing up in a family of six children, she graduated in 1978 from Forest Park High School in Ferdinand, Indiana. In 1982, Sue graduated from Purdue University with a Bachelor of Science in Industrial Engineering. And in 1996, she received her PhD from the University of Louisville. Before entering state politics, Sue founded the business consulting firm of Elsterman and Associates, and in 2006, she became the founding director of the University of Southern Indiana's Center for Applied Research. In 2010, Sue ran for the Indiana House of Representatives for the 74th District. She defeated 14-year incumbent and Democratic Majority Floor Leader, Russ Stilwell. On May 21st, 2012, Republican gubernatorial candidate Mike Pence announced the choice of Sue Elsterman as his running mate in the 2012 election. Together, they defeated Democratic opponents John Gregg and Vi Simpson in the general election. As Lieutenant Governor, Elsterman heads the Indiana State Department of Agriculture, the Office of Energy Development, the Indiana Housing and Community Development Authority, the Office of Community and Rural Affairs, and the Office of Tourism Development. Sue, you need a raise. She is a member of the St. Ferdinand Parish, where she and her husband are on the Strategic Planning Committee. She was previously a 20-year member of the Good Shepherd Catholic Church in Evansville, where she served on the Parish Council and Stewardship Commission, and was a Eucharistic minister and lector. She and her husband are the parents of four daughters. We are privileged to hear her challenge to our graduate. Sue, thank you for being with us today. Graduating class of 2014, friends, family members, please join me in welcoming Lieutenant Governor Sue Elsterman as our commencement speaker.
Thank you, Dr. Emberton, and I have to thank you especially for this little step up. Some of the women out there, we appreciate this extra height, so it's very good. But I certainly appreciate the invitation to be here at Huntington University's commencement. I know this is a very, very special day. I'm also honored to be here with our mayor of Huntington, the Honorable Brooks Fetters, who's in the house, so thank you so much. You know, Huntington University has already made a pretty indelible imprint on my memory. And you heard the story with the students in our Promoting the Good Works of Agriculture, of Indiana Agriculture competition. You know, that started because as Secretary of Agriculture, everywhere I went, I heard about how little today people understand modern agriculture and what it means, as 98% no longer live on the farm. And so if we were going to reach out to these 18 to 35 year olds who no longer had that opportunity, we wanted to do that in a non-traditional way. So gathering around my State Department of Agriculture, commodity leaders, and different industry groups and ag media, we sat down to think about how could we go about this. And we decided that the best people to ask would be some of those 18 to 35 year olds in our universities and engaging them in the task of how would we promote the good works of Indiana agriculture. And so you know here, this was no small task. There were 30 teams from 17 Indiana universities, both state and private, including Purdue and Notre Dame in the competition. And guess who won? Huntington University. Would you join me in some big applause? So I can say, coming from a small town, I'm always rooting on the small school. I think it's fabulous, but what you need to know is you had the best students, the best outcomes, the best media campaign. It was truly the best, and you deserved every bit of it, and we can't wait to get started using some of your ideas as we go forward. Further, I am told that this project has helped compel Huntington University to think about an agriculture major. Now, as your Secretary of Agriculture, I can tell you I commend that 100%. I hope that happens, because Indiana is a great place to be a farmer, to have an agribusiness, to own one, or to work for one. And we have some big companies like Dow AgriSciences, Elanco, and Bex Hybrids. Next month, I will lead an agriculture trade mission to China, and I know you have a special relationship with China already. We will also visit South Korea and Taiwan, as we see many opportunities for agriculture in Indiana. But today really is about Huntington University's graduates before me, your families and your loved ones, as we all know that though you've done most of the work, there are many people in this room have helped you do that heavy lifting along the way. And it takes the love and support of many to help each of us achieve our God-given potential. Graduates, you have been on a journey of discovery and have yet just begun to fully explore your own calling in life. For me, I knew I wanted to deep dive into areas most women of my time didn't, to see if I could succeed outside the cocoon of my little town of 2,200 and high school of 500, where I was used to being a pretty big fish in a small pond. Working as an engineer in several large companies and in several states helped me to understand that if I worked hard and stayed focused, I could compete and contribute in both of those arenas. That said, when our first child came, we were ready to move back to Indiana. And I treasure the time away to widen my view of the work, but even more, I treasure the return to our families and Indiana. Thus, on behalf of Governor Pence and me, I want to tell you that we hope you will choose to make your lives here in Indiana. More than ever before, Indiana needs you. If you have a desire to pursue opportunities away initially, okay, I understand, for a while. But know that Indiana, Huntington, Northeast Indiana, we all need you here if our communities will prosper, and we need your talent to be the driver of that prosperity. And if you are not a native Hoosier, and I know there are many in the crowd that are not native Hoosiers, we invite you to come here too to live, work, and raise a family. This is a wonderful state. Second, wherever you land, you know no one will ever tell you again, just as you heard in scripture before, you won't have that highly structured life where you will be pushed to do service hours and be engaged in your Christian community. Your service and faith life after graduation may be a true telling tale of whether you have truly educated for life, for a life of faith and service as defined by Huntington University's mission. Don't wait. Dive in with both feet in your faith community. If you stay where you live today, take a deeper role and engage in new ministries. If you are moving for a new job, waste no time at finding your church, becoming an active member, and continuing to grow in your walk with the Lord. You know, it just wouldn't be a commencement address if I didn't offer some deeper wisdom. So, here we go. The saying that what doesn't kill you makes you stronger is true. And now is the time not to kill yourself, but to explore how much stronger you might be. I was the first engineer and the first to pursue a PhD in my family, ever. When I began my undergrad, I was kind of hanging on by my fingernails just to stay in the engineering program and do well. And I was just too stubborn and determined to give up my freshman year. It was the first time in my life I knew what it meant to really work hard and still not be assured that you would be able to make it. By the time I graduated, I knew I wanted to continue learning, at least with a master's degree and maybe a PhD. Then God opened a tremendous career path to me in facilitating and teaching a balanced, creative, and analytical problem-solving methodology I learned on the job. He then opened the door when we were leaving Dallas to come back and do that work from Evansville. Now, conventional wisdom would have been go get another job, a traditional job, in another company, in the new city. But you know, I plunged through that window to start my own consultancy at the ripe old age of 26. Within a year, I realized that that was really my life's work, and I wanted to be an expert. I wanted to contribute to the scholarly body of knowledge, and I wanted to use the process to help in all kinds of organizations, businesses, churches, nonprofits, and government entities, all about making healthy change. So at age 28, with a two-year-old, I started my PhD at the University of Louisville, driving 2 hours each way, 3 days a week. Thankfully, my family lived along the way, and Granny took care of my daughter. The second daughter was born during spring break of one of the other semesters. Now, don't feel so bad. She turned out to be a National Merit Scholar. She did okay. I think there's learning in the womb. I don't know if anyone's done the research yet. But from there, it took another 5 years to complete the dissertation. So it all, to me, now sounds easy, but I can't tell you how many times I worried about whether I was capable of completing that PhD, if I could ever really earn that term doctor. I tell the story because it was a huge stretch to me. No one in my family had done those things that I said. It would have been so much easier to have just a traditional job or to just stick with the consulting as it was going. It would have been calmer to just settle in and take a local job. It would have been fine, except I knew I was called to do more. And that more has positioned me so much better today than I could have ever imagined. If someone had suggested back when I was 22 that I would be Lieutenant Governor of Indiana, I would have kindly told you you had lost your mind. Yet, as I look back, I am now so grateful for the many doors and windows that God has placed in my path that have led me to this role. So this is how God prepares us for what is ahead. I cannot tell you what purpose God has for each of you. I can tell you that if you follow his call, the ride will be exciting. He will not ask of you more than you are capable of giving. And even when you fail, he will put that learning to good use. So I'm going to leave you with three pieces of career advice. I was told to give you a challenge. One, pursue a career, not a job. You know, I held a number of less than glamorous jobs, including third shift supervisor in Dallas, Texas, working nights and thinking, okay, I have an engineering degree. What am I doing here working nights, Christmas Eve, my first year out of college, and I'm here instead of at home with my family. Now, I value those experiences tremendously because as Lieutenant Governor, our administration is completely focused on job creation. Number two, seek out and take on the projects beyond your job description. Do the job you are given, of course, but always do more, ask for more, and perform more. Look around and see what else, as my chief of staff, Tanya Brothers Bridge, always says, needs done. Or look for an opportunity to help the organization you serve. Help your fellow colleagues. Ask your boss how you can contribute further. And number three, don't follow the crowd. Careers and lives are personal. There should be no two alike. Build your career and your life as your personal novel to God. Einstein said, "The one who follows the crowd will likely get no further than the crowd. The one who walks alone is likely to find himself or herself in places where no one has ever been before." So in closing, Huntington University has prepared you well. You have prepared yourself well. Now it's time to jump off the diving board. Do it with gusto, do it with flair, do it with great thanksgiving to God, and by all means, make a difference. As the fond Irish blessing says, may the road rise to meet you. May the wind always be at your back. May the sun shine warm on your face and the rain fall soft on your fields. And until we meet again, and I surely hope we will, may God hold you in the hollow of his hand. God bless you, graduates, your family, and your loved ones.
Thank you, Lieutenant Governor, for that incredible challenge to our graduating students. That was inspiring, and we thank you. Graduates, you know that I had an opportunity to share my comments with you, some through our lunches and breakfast today, some with you at rehearsal. But I do have one more comment to share with you before we go through the actual ceremony. You have all worked very hard, and you've all come a very long way. But it's fair to say as students that you did not undertake this journey on your own. Along the way, there have been others who have helped you to complete your education. And with your permission, I'd like to recognize those individuals who've played a major role in helping you reach this milestone today. If you are the parent or guardian of one of our graduates today, would you please stand and remain standing? Thank you for your support of these graduates today. You may be seated. If you are the sibling or child of one of our graduates today, would you please stand and let us recognize you? Thank you for your support of these graduates today. If you are the spouse of one of our graduates, would you please stand and let us say thank you to you? Graduates, let us thank these individuals for their help and continue through your life by making a difference in the lives of other people. I think it would also be appropriate at this time for us to recognize another special group of individuals who have helped you since the day you've arrived at this institution. If you are a staff or a faculty member of Huntington University, would you please stand and let our students say thank you. Thank you. You may be seated. At this time, before we present the candidates, I'd like to pray over our graduates. Please join me in this prayer. Lord, thank you. Thank you for the quiet of the day. Thank you for allowing us a time to just celebrate. Lord, I do not know the plans that you have for our students and what you have for these graduates, but I do know that your word says that you have plans for them to prosper and to be successful. Lord, I also know that you formed them in their mother's womb. and that you have a special honor for them, for those that are called, for those that follow you. And Lord, I pray that you would help their dreams come to fulfillment. I pray that you would call them to do things big and small for you, but all things for your honor and your glory. In your precious name we pray. Amen.
President Emberton, distinguished guests, students, parents, families, and friends, as Interim Vice President for Academic Affairs, I am pleased to present this class of graduates to be awarded the designated bachelor's, associate's, and master's degrees from Huntington University. These students have been diligent in the pursuit of their education and in achieving the goals that they have set for themselves. Their accomplishments are substantial and honoring to God. They are well prepared for a career and life of service to society. These students have completed all or nearly all of the requirements for their respective degrees. Most have now completed the degree indicated. Some are participating today but will receive their actual diplomas at the end of the summer session. We ask that you hold your applause until all of the degrees are awarded. Dean of Graduate and Adult Programs, Dr. Steve Holtrip, will first present the candidates for master's degrees.
President Emberton, as Dean of Graduate and Professional Programs, it is my pleasure to present the candidates for designated master degrees. We first present candidates for the Master of Arts degrees. Will the candidates for Master of Arts degrees please stand? These students have prepared themselves in areas of ministry or counseling. Many are already serving the church and Christian community in their chosen fields. They are prepared to honor God and society in professional service, impacting their world for Christ. Will the candidates for Master of Education degrees please stand? These students have prepared themselves for classroom teaching and leadership. Most are already in the teaching profession, all of them in this case. They are prepared to honor God and society in professional service, impacting their world for Christ.
To each of you, as presented, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Huntington University, on the recommendation of the faculty, and conditioned upon satisfactory completion of all requirements, I hereby confer upon you the designated master's degree and deliver your diploma as a testimonial thereof.
Receiving the Master of Arts degree, 2014, Ryan Joseph Beeching. Kelsey Lynn Box Summers. Valerie Brummenschenkel. Joseph Daniel Bush. Hannah Rose Chupp. John Paul Cole. Matthew Austin Culler. Sarah Gagan Taylor. Aubrey Amanda Garner. Philip A. Hall. Allison Lynn Johnson. Eric James Kelly. Andrew Lee Rieger. Justin Andrew Schrock. Brent Christopher Sickle. Madeline Dawn Spring. Aaron M. Straub. Receiving the Master of Education degree 2014, Kara Marie Foltz. Curtis Ray Hines. Kyle Joseph Wood. Let's congratulate these degree recipients.
President Emberton, I now present the candidates for bachelor's degrees. Will the candidates for Bachelor of Arts degrees please stand? Will the candidates for Bachelor of Music degrees please stand? Will the candidates for Bachelor of Science degrees please stand? Will the candidates for Bachelor of Science in Nursing degrees please stand? Will the candidates for Bachelor of Social Work degrees please stand? These men and women have studied in the liberal arts and sciences and in various professional fields. They have prepared themselves well for their chosen careers and are poised to impact their world for Christ. They are prepared to honor God and society in professional service.
To each of you, as presented by the virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Huntington University, on the recommendation of the faculty and conditioned upon satisfactory completion of all requirements, I hereby confer upon you the designated bachelor's degrees and deliver your diploma as a testimonial thereof.
Candidates may be seated until their row is called. Receiving the Bachelor of Arts degree 2014, Sarah Elizabeth Armstrong. Eric Montgomery Banton. Joshua Paul Barber. Samantha Joanne Bierbauer. Nicole Renee Beer. Matthew Joel Bittner. Jace Jeffrey Blackburn. Karen Ann Bolenbacher. Charles E. Booth. Matthew Scott Brown, in absentia. Blair Anna Caldwell, summa cum laude. Micah James Christensen, cum laude. Joshua Michael Cookingham, cum laude. Rosa M. Cruz. Abigail Grace Cruz. Pryor in absentia. Allison Sabri Dozit. Megan Ashley Fomley. Rachel Elizabeth Ford in absentia. Andrew David Frischman, cum laude. Melissa Ann Fuller. Caitlin Marie Grimm. Michelle Christine Embry, magna cum laude. Allison Jane Finley, cum laude. Melissa Ann Fuller. Melissa Lynn Grossman, cum laude. Haley Nicole Hast. Danielle Jolyn Hisson, in absentia. Brooks David Hooley. Jessica Marie Krause, summa cum laude. Jennifer Marie Lai. Marcy Michelle McDougall. Joshua McIntyre. Magna cum laude. Jessica Noelle McKinley, summa cum laude. Kelsey Ann Merrick, magna cum laude. Stephanie Amanda Morin. Jessica Marie Musselman, magna cum laude. Emily Nicole Myers, summa cum laude. Mallory Joy Utman. Stephen Richard Planelp. Jeffrey Dean Price. Emily Louise Russell. Kaylee Jo Searles, in absentia. Tyler Eugene, James Eugene Skinner, in absentia. Margaret. Margaret Rose Slagenwhite, magna cum laude. Leah Evangeline Smith, in absentia. Zoe Ann Eastwood. William David Stauffer, summa cum laude. Nathaniel Jacob Sullivan, magna cum laude. Michelle Lynn Thalen, in absentia. Audrey Nicole Trout. Rebecca Joyce Trout. Jonathan James Wagle. William Cody Walters. Laura Elizabeth Watson. Leah Elizabeth Wagle, magna cum laude in absentia. Ashley Nicole Williams. Receiving the Bachelor of Music 2014, Johanna Marie Karen, magna cum laude. Jacob Hartzell Smith, summa cum laude. Receiving the Bachelor of Science 2014, Jessica K. Abel, cum laude. Drew J. Adams. Blake Michael Ayers. Michael David Ayers. Julie Ann Baker, with honor. Chase Gregory Parnell. Brandon Kyle Ballschmidt, in absentia. Courtney Renee Barker, with honor. Nicholas Anthony Barlow. Kendall Frederick Goddard Bates, also receiving a Bachelor of Arts degree. Melanie Jewel Beachy. Tyler Keff Beasley, cum laude. Rachel May Belland, magna cum laude. Lindsay Renee Bergren. Daniel Stephen Binkowski, summa cum laude. Jordan E. Bishop. Megan Christine Bittner. Trevor Jennings Bortz. Marcus James Bowers. Lauren Nicole Brown with honor. Volodymyr Andreevich Bunichenko. Daniel Brian Burnworth. Carolyn Inez Burroughs. Lindsay Megan Burson. Andrew Thomas Cahill. Adam Kane. Aaron Daniel Carlson. Benjamin Noah Carlson, magna cum laude. Nicholas David Clayball, in absentia. Evan Hartman Clark. Victoria Ann Cohagan, magna cum laude. Joshua David Cooley. Stacy Marie Cressman, summa cum laude. Cody Joseph Crippen. Samantha Kubik. Joshua James Doolin, cum laude. Jennifer Lynn Dorio, cum laude. Melissa Joy Drake, cum laude. Dane Thomas Drew, with honor. Austin Michael Drummond, cum laude. Jamie Nicole Duchesne. Justin Anthony Dunaway. Catherine Elizabeth Esch. Jacob Wayne Essig. Dustin Clay Forney. Rodney Lee Forrester Jr. Hannah Elizabeth Fox. Sean Daniel Franklin in absentia. Timothy Glenn Fulton in absentia. Kristen Elizabeth Gardner. Kyle Christopher Geis, summa cum laude. Kaylee Michelle Giggy. Andrew Goebel, with honor. Laura Renee Good. Kendall Austin Green, magna cum laude. Adam J. Grimmie, with honor. Brandon Michael Groff, cum laude. Molly Marie Gropp. Lisa Hambrick Johnson, with honor. Regina Lynn Hands. Whitney Colleen Hands, cum laude. Kevin Wesley Hast, cum laude. Tanel Marie Hahn, with honor. Ashley Louise Haynes, magna cum laude. Hannah Elizabeth Hostetler, summa cum laude. Preston Reese Hubler, summa cum laude. Kyle David Hoopengarner. Jessica Lauren Hott. Alan Matthew Huffman. Jose Alberto Hungria. Sherry Sue Hurd. Marcus Ryan Ingram. Kyle Andrew Johnlows. Jennifer Lee Johnson, in absentia. Katie Lou Johnson. Leah Mary Johnson, magna cum laude. Matthew Ryan Johnson. Tyler Scott Johnson, in absentia. Weston Paul Johnson, magna cum laude. Alexandra Elizabeth Jones Carlson, summa cum laude. Andrea Christine Julien, in absentia. Greg M. Kaminsky, in absentia. Megan Nicole Karst. Vladislav Hudzi, summa cum laude. Alexander Scott Kite, cum laude. Catherine Rose Kinneman, in absentia. Katie Elizabeth Naus, cum laude. Logan Boulay Knox. Alyssa Paige Krause, magna cum laude. Alyssa Renee Kraus. Kenneth Ray Lane. Emily Marie Lapham. Bobe Lee, summa cum laude. Johan Lee, magna cum laude in absentia. Horain Horendel Lewis. Angela Noel Lipsy, cum laude. Charity Hope Little. Yeah! Holly Janice Lutton, summa cum laude. Yeah! Gina Liu, cum laude in absentia. Janessa Gwen Tilsey, Mace Jack. Abigail Marie Madison, summa cum laude. Sean Andrew Marion. Andrew Evan Mattingly, summa cum laude. Tyler R. McCachran. Derek Lee McKinney. Shane Michael Merriman, cum laude. Caitlin Sarah Milligan. Brittany Elaine Morgan. Adam Edward Myers. Matthew Robert Nelson, cum laude. Carolyn Ann Newell. Lee Edward Neuswanger. Larry Thomas Nutt, with honor. Kendall Ogle, cum laude. Caleb Robert Overfelt, magna cum laude. Jockton Timothy Neary Owen. David Warren Pancook, cum laude in absentia. James Hilton Innes Parker, cum laude. Maria Esther Pavon Guzman. Chelsea Joe Piper, magna cum laude. James Martin Pope Jr. Riley Brian Powell. Sabira Rakimova, summa cum laude. Kylie Jean Renfrew, cum laude. Gary Michael Rice. Catherine Elizabeth Rinchek, cum laude. John Andrew Ripke. Sherry Ann Rosebrook. Dustin Allen Rutledge. Anne Kanaga Savariar, magna cum laude. Emily Ann Schnorr, magna cum laude. Thank you for your patience today. Kyle August Schwartfeger, Rebecca J. Sebastian, magna cum laude. Luke Robert Sedwick. Sean Andrew Sewell. Kelsey D. Shoemaker, cum laude. Andrew Jeffrey Simmons. Robert Jordan Simpson. Yes. Sierra Lene Smith. Cameron James Smith. Zachary T. Sparks. Peja Nicole Speed. Jennifer Luann Spittler, with honor, in absentia. Stephen Andrew Sproul, cum laude. Tina Marie Stevenson. Gia Marie Stockman, with honor. Jacob Armstrong Stone. Aaron Lee Strange. David Calvin Stringham. Fred Terrence Tolson. Andrew Michael Trausch. Aaron D. Tremaine. Matthew Terry Twig. Brianne L. Tisland. Jordan Taylor Van Engen, magna cum laude. Brandon J. Vantland. Stephen Neil Verkota. Olivia Lynn Walker, cum laude. Lee Waltz. Sarah Marguerite Jean Watson. Stephanie Ann Wiegold, cum laude. Sarah Marie Wall. Rachel Lynette Wonderlin, in absentia. Elias Jackson Wood, cum laude. Jason Clark Wright, cum laude. Emily K. Yarman, magna cum laude. Brandon Lee Yoder. Receiving the Bachelor of Science in Nursing 2014, Caitlin Ray Adams. Rachel Rosa Bayonne, cum laude. Paige Marie Bontrager, summa cum laude. Carissa Ann Boyd. Miranda Nicole Boyds, summa cum laude. Brooke Ann Capalbo. Gwendolyn Ann Cottle, with honor. Tamara Dolores Files, with honor. Adam Zachary Guy, cum laude. Esther Suzanne Kaufman. Abby Marie Keister. Caleb Eugene Little. Caitlin Grace Maggart. Megan Alexandra Meyer. Sarah J. Miller Jennings, also receiving a Bachelor of Science degree. Kona Musa. Tamara Jo Rush. Lindsay Rose Schellebarger. Kelly Ann Stace, cum laude. Kaylee Ann Woodcox. Receiving the Bachelor of Social Work 2014, Gina Nicole Bucaras, summa cum laude. Megan Rose Dean, magna cum laude. Samantha Lee Dunn. Erica Lauren Eisenberg. Minkalu Mambu, also receiving a Bachelor of Arts degree. Stephanie Jane Mihich, magna cum laude. Jessica Lauren Perry, magna cum laude. Juliana Julen Ruiz Moreno, cum laude. Will all graduates receiving a bachelor's degree please stand, move your tassel, and receive congratulations.
You may be seated. You as students today have been recognized as graduates, but I would like to introduce another group of graduates that are with us today. Our 50-year reunion graduates, the class of 1964, I would like to ask them to stand as I call their names and to remain standing until all have been introduced. First, Donetta Bruner, Gary Graham, Henrietta Grog, Patricia Howenstein, Donald Hendrickson, Nancy Jularet, Emmett Lippe, Kirby Keller, Barbara Maxwell, Arlen Reinhard, and Gerald Smith. Please join me in congratulating these graduates from the class of 1964. You may be seated.
Lastly, Dr. Emberton, I now present the candidates for the associate degree. Will the candidates for the Associate of Arts degree please stand? Will the candidates for the Associate of Science degree please stand? These individuals have completed programs that have focused on specific careers. They are prepared to honor God and society in productive service.
To each of you, as presented, by the virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Huntington University, on the recommendation of the faculty and conditioned upon satisfactory completion of all the requirements, I hereby confer upon you the designated associate's degree and deliver you the diploma as a testimonial thereof.
Tyler D. Baer in absentia and Christina K. Branning in absentia. Tabitha Lynn Brown. Samantha Lynn DeWells. Ryan Christopher Douglas. Bruce Allen Hansen. And Heather Renee Kindler. Let's congratulate these degree recipients.
To conclude this very special ceremony, We will stand and join together in the singing of the alma mater that is printed in your program. Jacob Smith, a member of the class of 2014, will come forward to lead us. This will be followed by the benediction led by our campus pastor, Reverend Arthur Wilson. A special word of instruction to family and friends. Our graduates and faculty will recess down the center aisle and meet you outside the front entrance or in the gymnasium if it is raining. And I have no clue whether it is or it is not, so good luck. Please remain in your seats until the recessional has passed. Please stand now for the singing of the alma mater, followed by the benediction, and remain standing for the recessional.
By the winding Wabash River, high above the rest, stands our dear old alma mater, Huntington, the best. Alma mater, we thy children
Let us pray. Everlasting Father, through your steadfast love, you've graced us with a blessing to witness this day. At this moment, we stand in awe at the work of your hands, realizing that in the lives of these students, you have crafted the perfect plan. Perfect not because the road traveled has been smooth and easy. Perfect not because waking up for classes and chapel was always pleasing. Perfection rests upon the accomplishments of these graduates, not for them to obtain the glory, but so that this day would provide testimony about how their lives have been refined by your story. We offer praise unto you for those who sacrificed much in order to make this moment possible. We thank you for those who toiled so that these students might learn. We salute you for family, friends, and mentors who refused to relinquish hope in order that these graduates would continue to persevere in the midst of uncertain times. Lord, you are good, and your mercy endures forever. As members of this graduating class leave one another to pursue new opportunities and experiences, would you give them eyes to see the needs of the least of these? Would you provide them with ears to hear the cries and moans of injustice? Would you enable their hands and feet to tend to the wounds of the afflicted and neglected? Would you grant them with hearts that beat only to the rhythm of your holy word? May the class of 2014 live only to serve you with the totality of their being. Now to him who is able to do far more abundantly beyond all that we could ask or think, according to the power that works within us, to him be the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever. And let the church say, amen. Thank you.
Thank you.